I don't need to study. I just play on my games.
Did you study?
No.
I need to study.
I actually studied this time.
Good morning, Huskies. My name is Sadaf.
And my name is Kiana, recognizing Red Ribbon Week, our annual drug-free lifestyle campaign.
Today's Wednesday, October 23rd.
Please stand for our nation's pledge.
Alright, let's do this.
Nine years old in Texas, in Arlington, went to see the Rangers play the Mariners. The Mariners still had Alex Rodriguez, still had Ken Griffey Jr., still had Randy Johnson, Jay Buhner, Edgar Martinez. And I got to see Ken Griffey Jr. play center field. He hit like a bases clearing triple to take the lead late in the game, and then he robbed a home run to end the game. It was something special. It was a perfect high to have as a baseball fan, but as a kid, just watching your favorite players and some of the best at what they do go out there and really love it. I love baseball that much. That helped me get through school and figure out how to get good grades and pay attention enough in class to understand and pick up on things. And when it came to parties and things like that, I can't miss practice. I can't be getting in trouble. Can't be getting in trouble with the law. Can't have any DUIs, things like that, because I love baseball that much. I want to do what I saw when I was 9 years old, playing in that major league ballpark. I want a chance to do it. I don't know if I'm going to make it, but I want to give myself the best chance to do so. And I was so afraid that I wouldn't get a chance to live out a dream that I sacrificed for and that my parents sacrificed for. My parents, they laid a foundation as far as raising you, of course, and kind of making you in tune to living below your means when it comes to financial things or just treating people with respect and things like that. And I remember playing summer ball, junior Olympic teams in East Cobb in Georgia growing up in high school. And I played with some really good players. And guys that, some were drafted, some went on to play in the major leagues, some went on to be good college players, some didn't. We're not all gonna make it. But at times you would see them get bored with baseball and say, hey man, we're gonna go to this party, we're gonna do that. Like, man, we play for a great team right now. We have a great platform to get exposure to play against the best in the country, and I don't wanna waste that. Those decisions and those things that they allowed me to see at a young age, that sticks with me today. And when I have to make decisions on where I want to sign as a free agent, where I would like to live in the off season, whatever it is, who you're going to spend your time with, family, friends, what have you. It just starts at a young age for me. And I feel like it starts at a young age for all of us as far as the influences we gain. And then today for myself at an older age, I'm still 26, I'm still young, but I feel like I can make a pretty good educated decision on what I need for myself and my family going forward. Andrew Wilmot was a great teammate to me, but a great teammate to everybody, great friend. And Andy was just the kind of person that, he didn't have the most talent or anything like that when it came to being on the baseball field, but he was going to affect the game however he could. He brightened up a room whenever he came around, and you were always just happy to see him. He always had a grin on his face. He was always making people laugh. And when he passed away after his car accident, it hit everybody. It hit home for everybody. Of course, it hit home for me, but when it hits home on a ball club, like, that's family. It helped me get through it, knowing that it wasn't just me going through it alone. And a part of why I wear the number 22 is to give back to him and for his mom to have that. And his mom, their family, friends, everyone around, my teammates, the teammates that we share together. So it's just something that we can all do together and kind of fight it together, that sadness, and turn it into a positive. There's one piece of advice that I could pass on to the younger generation of America. It would be that just understand that nobody's perfect. Everything happens for a reason. You know, we're human beings and we're gonna mess up, we're gonna make mistakes, but how you decide to go forward with that is what's gonna make the character in you. So what you do when nobody's looking, how you conduct yourself, you know, whether it's on a baseball field, whether it's in a classroom, whether it's at work, whether it's at home with your parents, whether it's with your kids when you become a parent, all the above is just, you know, how you overcome the tough times, because it's not gonna be easy. My name is Jason Heywood, right fielder for the Chicago Cubs. Baseball is my natural high. What's yours?
Let's celebrate Red Ribbon Week and annual anti-drug campaign by participating in our weekly dress-up days. Today is Twin Day. Did you match with a friend? Tomorrow is Catch a Wave to Happy Future Day. Wear your Hawaiian stuff gear or dress as a techie tourist. And Friday is not only Fright Night. Hawaii Halloween dance is a dream of drug-free life by wearing your pajamas. Celebrate a drug-free life by participating in our Red Ribbon Week, Spirit Week.
Our first dance of the year, Fright Night, will take place this Friday, October 25th, from 3:30 to 5:30 in the NPR. Tickets are on sale during lunch until Thursday. We will not sell tickets the day of the dance, so don't wait or you may miss out. In order to buy a ticket, you will need your student ID or your Chromebook, and $5 cash only. Prepare now for the scariest dance of the year, Fright Night.
Attention 7th graders, the votes are in the 7th grader, the 7th grade t-shirt design and a 7-Eleven style logo. The t-shirts are on sale until October 31st. Please see your math or advisory teacher for an order form. Be sure to bring your completed order form and $15 cash only to Mrs. Neighbors in room 701 during advisory. We can't wait to see our Hillsdale 7th graders showing their school spirit on Fridays.
Hey basketball stars, come out and demonstrate your free throws at the annual HMS Hoop Shoot Challenge. It will take place today, October 23rd, during lunch in the NPR. Top finalists from our school will participate in the county competition at the end of November. All students are welcome to participate during their lunchtime. We hope to see you there.
Now let's go over to our special guest.
Good morning, Huskies. Principal Wallace here. Just wanted to give you a couple pieces of information. First off, as they said, this Friday we have the best dance of the year and the scariest dance of the year. Just a little reminder on that. When you come to the dance, you'll have to put your backpacks and all your stuff in the 200 pod area, which will lock up, and we don't open that until the end of the dance. So please make sure your parents know they can't pick you up before the end of the dance because your stuff's going to be locked up. Second thing is, a lot of you have been really doing a great job at sports leadership. When the whistle blows, you're walking the balls over to a sports leader person, but some of you are still continuing to play or kicking and throwing the ball. And if that happens, then you're not going to be able to participate in sports leadership anymore, because we have to trust you to safely take the ball back to the sports leaders. And then finally, on sports leadership, remember, if you are excused from PE, that also means you can't participate in sports leader. So it's pretty obvious if you're wandering around in a cast on your foot or your arm that you should not be down there. This is for your safety. So if you can't participate in PE, that also means you can't participate in lunch sports leadership for our 7th and 8th graders. All right? Have a wicked Wednesday, everybody.